Welcome to Rasa Studio. You've officially landed on the Rasa Studio homepage. In this video, we'll have a click-through of all the different sections in Rasa Studio so that you can calmly navigate the interface like a pro. At a high level, building conversational user journeys with Calm requires a couple of key steps. You need to, for example, define what the assistant can do and specify all the necessary steps to complete different user journeys. And of course, lastly, call any backend services required to complete a task. Different side panels in Rasa Studio will help you accomplish all of these tasks and more so that you can build, test, and maintain these conversational user journeys. Now, if we look at the menu moving from top to bottom, the first component that you can see in the top left-hand corner is the name of your studio instance. I've called mine Lauren Opspot since my name is Lauren, and this AI assistant was created to help with internal operations and human resources processes here at Rasa. However, since this is a shared studio instance, I can also click here and toggle between some of the other AI assistants I have access to that some of my fellow colleagues are building. All right, now let's move to the next section, which is flows. If I click here, you can see we're actually already on the flows page. Flows is the main menu of the Rasa Studio interface, and it's also quite an important component of the Calm dialog system. What you can see here is a list of lots of different flows, and let's actually just click into a flow so you can have a look at what they are. Now, you can think of a flow a little bit like a roadmap for a specific business process. For example, this one's called Leave Vacation Policy, and it lists out the different steps that we need to take in order to provide a user with the vacation policy based on their geography. Let's go back to the flows menu. You can see we've got other flows. For example, here we've got another one called Leave Vacation Remaining, and each of these flows have a name, a flow name, a description, which is an overview of what the flow does, when it was last updated, and whether or not it's ready for training. Let's take a look at the flow description. One of the things I want to highlight is that the flow description here is much, much more than just a reference description of what the flow should do. The flow description has a real and essential purpose. It's the text that's read by the LLM in our Calm dialog system. So when someone says something like, how much time do I have off remaining? Calm would ask the language model to read that utterance in the conversation that happened previously, so in the context, and then decide which flow is best suited to help the user. In this case, for this type of question, the leave time off remaining flow would be the most suitable option to support the user with their query. We'll talk a lot more about flows and best practices to name and define them in the following video. All right. Now, an important thing to keep in mind is that when you're using Calm, you can use flow descriptions to help route you to and from different parts of the AI assistant, or you can also use NLU. You can use intents. For those that have worked on different AI assistants previously, probably the concept of NLU or natural language understanding will be familiar. And what we have here is a NLU content management system. Here we can see lots of different intents, and we can also see all of the intent examples. Within the intent example, I can also click into, for example, the intent example and annotate a specific entity. So here's a great place to really manage, edit, update, delete all of your intents and entities. If the concept of intents is new to you, definitely check out the intents video. I'll link it in the description to make sure you can get caught up. Later in the series, of course, we'll look at how NLU classifier can be used in Calm, especially when we focus on activating flows. Now, let's move back to the flows panel here, and we can see in the very top hand right hand side corner is a train button. Now, after you've built a new flow and set it to ready to train, or the same thing for intents, if you've made a new intent and set it to ready to train, when you press this button, what'll happen is the system will save your progress and it will train a new model, including all of the different changes that you've made. Once the training is complete, your progress is saved and you can probably move on to the next natural step in your process, and that's try out what you just built. So let's move along to the Try Your Assistant panel. And here you can see a little chat widget pop up that is connected to the AI assistant that I've built in Rasa Studio. So we talked about, for example, time off remaining. I'll ask the same question, how much time off remaining do I have? And I can just ask the question right here in the panel. You can see, okay, I've got 12 days of vacation left. This is super useful, again, for kind of debugging or trialing things that you've just built. You can even share it with your colleagues and allow them to give a quick try right here in Rasa Studio. All right, let's move along to the last section that we want to cover today. This is the version section. What you can see here in the version section is a randomly generated version name, the date and time stamp that it was created, who it was created by, and of course, whether it's the current version, whether it's just a successful version, or whether the version failed on training. So basically, every single time you press that train button, a new version will be created. The most recent training will, of course, become the current version, and then the prior versions are still listed in this version log here. All right, now that you know how to navigate within the key sections of Rasa Studio, let's continue this journey in the following video where we're gonna learn all about how to set up our first flow and how to activate it in different ways. Follow along in the next video.